Good morning. It is an honor and a privilege to offer an invocation with you in today's celebration of academic accomplishments. Invocation is a turning from the concrete and tangible aspects of these accomplishments to the intangible. That which provided ability to persevere, when humanly speaking, it seemed impossible to study one more hour, pass one more test, or produce one more written assignment. Yet you succeeded. The spirit that underlies your success is an intangible, an unseen force or power that cannot be analyzed as the points in your final grade average. Yet it is as real as the books you read, the videos you watched, or the papers you prepared. Among us, there are multiple ways of acknowledging this spirit. Different beliefs and varying interpretations of that hidden power that impels us forward when finite humanity seems at its lowest ebb. Yet, without that spirit, none of us would be standing here as we are today. Therefore, united in the joy of accomplishment and in thanksgiving for the great achievements being recognized, let all present address the spirit within according to personal preference. Let these individual reflections in some way coalesce and become a palpable outpouring of love, respect, caring, and support for the entire graduating class of 2011 as the ceremony continues.
Oh, say, can you see? What so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars.
Seated. It is my pleasure to introduce the distinguished members of the college community represented on the platform and our honored guests. Please rise when I read your name and remain standing until these introductions are complete. The audience will please hold their glorious applause until after everyone has been introduced. In our front row to my right is Nancy Pierce, chair of the college's advisory board. Michael Marr, representing the Community College System of New Hampshire. Will Arvello, president of Great Bay Community College. Ian Jameson, today's commencement speaker. Harvey Hill, Vice Chairman of the Board of Trustees for the Community College System of New Hampshire. Diane Chin, Vice President for Academic Affairs. Renee Plummer, today's honorary degree recipient. And in the second row, Doug Bates, member of the College Advisory Board. Christine Carberry, also a member of the College Advisory Board, as is Stella Scammon. Dr. Sister Helen Burke, Christy Silva, today's student speaker, Sarah Bedingfield, the Associate Vice President for Academic Services, William Marcello, member of the Board of Trustees of the Community College System of New Hampshire, and Ronald Rio, member of the Board of Trustees for the Community College System of New Hampshire. I would also at this time ask our faculty department heads and program chairs seated to my right to please rise. And for our other distinguished faculty and staff to rise as well. It is now my pleasure to introduce President Will Arvelo, who will begin today's commencement with words of welcome. Will.
Greetings and welcome to graduates, family members, friends, faculty, and staff. This is a rare day in your life as well as ours. For you, it comes once or maybe several times in your life. For the college, it is a culmination of all the work that we have accomplished collectively and a celebration of that collective success. I want to thank you for having chosen Great Bay Community College. You could have chosen another college, but you chose us, and we're the richer for it. People are under the impression that going to college is a one-way enrichment process. But it is not. We also learn from you, and we get better because you hold us to the highest standards. So thank you. I hope that we have met your expectations, and that as you leave us, that you will continue to stay engaged with us. Certainly, I wish all of you to become rich so that I can go to you in a few years and ask for a donation for the college, because I would love to build a student community center. But short of you becoming rich, my hope for you is that you will achieve your dreams, that you continue to push forward, and continue to discover. Many times our path of discovery takes us in many different directions and drops us in strange places and strange situations. If I stop to count, I must have held at least 75 jobs during my lifetime, and still got another 50 years to go, so you can imagine. I have traveled in at least 25 countries, but I will also tell you that I have also been homeless. And today I stand here with you, loving my job, and making a difference both on the seacoast and in New Hampshire. The point that I'm trying to make is that it took all of these experiences to get me here. Life is never a straight line. And even if you had the choice, why would you want to walk in a straight line? I was curious, hungry to learn, experiencing new things and places. Through all these experiences, I have developed confidence, a strong work ethic, and I learned to appreciate our infinite diversity. So my message to you is to always keep moving forward, to get out, to explore, and to continue to learn. Finally, remember to always wander in wonderland and wonderment, achieving some wonder work that will be wondrous. I now want to introduce Harvey Hill, who is vice chair of our system board, to bring welcome. Harvey?
Good morning. The trustees are appointed by New Hampshire's Governing Council to provide stewardship, oversight, and advocacy for New Hampshire's community colleges. We are proud to be part of this event of such meaning and importance to each of you, and we bring you greetings and congratulations from the full board. As a student, you may have limited contact with the trustees, but I want you to know that you are the reasons we serve as board members. We are inspired by your ambitions, humbled by your commitment to learning, and motivated by the mission of helping the college meet your needs. The graduates come to the stage this morning having traveled a number of different learning paths. You leave, some to seek further degree programs, some to start or continue a career, and some to return again as learners at a later date. Persistence and determination brought you to this moment. There were times it wasn't easy, times when demands were overbearing. That's often the way with gaining things of value. You've not only earned a degree, but you've earned the respect from your peers and the pride of your family and friends. The people of this state have come to demand a responsive and high-quality community college system. We boast of the thousands of learners entering our doors each year. But most of all, we boast of each of you as you graduate and do us proud in your upcoming endeavors. To those who help celebrate with us, faculty, staff, family, friends, a special recognition for your ongoing encouragement and support of these students who have reached a new milestone. Our thanks go to you on behalf of today's graduates for all you have done. As teachers, the endless hours of preparation and nurturing. As staff, the guidance and support day in and day out. As family and friends, the times you contributed financial support, babysat the kids, helped with the dishes, ran errands, cooked meals, and provided a welcoming shoulder to lean on and an encouraging smile when needed. Thank you for all being here today. The last several years have witnessed a re-energized, retooled, and expanded community college system. We appreciate the contributions that you, today's graduates, have made to that effort, and we appreciate that you have brought honor and pride to Great Bay Community College. We look forward to keeping you on the team as alumni in the years to come. Congratulations on this special day.
Our commencement speaker is Ann Jamison, Chief Executive Officer of Portsmouth Regional Hospital. Ann Jamison has a legal background and holds an MBA, but she also has been in the trenches as a registered nurse, which gives her a unique viewpoint into all aspects of the hospital environment. She was previously Chief Operating Officer and General Counsel of Anna Jakes Hospital in Newburyport, Mass., and joined Parkland Medical Center in Derry, New Hampshire, as CEO in 2005. She became CEO of Portsmouth Regional Hospital in 2009. Ann's varied background serves her well in this position, where she does everything from hashing out contracts to understanding and meeting the unique medical needs of our community. Before Anna Jakes Hospital, Ann held several positions at Cerner Corporation in Kansas City, Missouri, and worked at hospitals in Massachusetts and Florida. Ann is also an active member of both the medical and local communities. She's a fellow of the American College of Health Care Executives and a current board member of the New Hampshire Hospital Association in the secretary-treasurer role and on the advisory committee to the Healthcare Management Department at UNH, as well as a past member of the Derry Boys and Girls Club, New Hampshire Charitable Foundation, United Way, and the Derry Chamber of Commerce. Ann received her bachelor's degree from Worcester State College and an MBA from Anna Maria College in Paxton, Massachusetts. She also has a Juris Doctor from Massachusetts School of Law in Andover. Please help me welcome Ann Jameson.
Okay, first of all, I don't write any speeches, so I'm not reading anything. I'm going to talk to some of you. How many of you were tired today because you may have partied a little bit too much last night? None of you? Okay, a few were honest. That's part of where you're going. You've heard a few people before. How many of you have been really nice to your family, significant others, during this journey you've had here? Have you ever been short? Oh, some have been nice. Have you ever been asked your family to read your paper, or could they talk and they make a comment that you don't like, so then you find yourself arguing with them? I think some of you probably have. I do have two sons, and one of mine did his master's a few years ago in criminal justice, and I know there's several of you in criminal justice here. Criminal justice majors, don't go to a lawyer to ask them to read your papers. It doesn't work. Okay, fruits of the spirit, attenuation, all those things, different as a lawyer. Today, though, in all seriousness, is a huge day. When I asked for the stats of how many of you different age bracket and different majors you're going into, I hope you chose your major because you were passionate about something. Many of you look like this may be a second career or something you waited for a long time. Your family's here. They know what you went through. I'm sure some of you were thinking some classes that you passed, you wonder, what was that professor even saying? I never understood it, but I still got a C or a B. That a true statement? Okay, we all been there. Nothing different, we're all the same. But what's different is I want you to walk away today with something. This is a life-changing event. You may not think it is, and it's what we all say. It's down to the point, if you all go buy, if some of you are going to start new employment and you want to buy a new car, you now get to check off that box that you're a college grad. It's something different. The expectation that I have for all of you, many of you are in healthcare, those of you in nursing, I'm going to hold you to a higher standard. I expect you to do different. You touch people's lives forever. You become part of someone's memories. Those that are in veterinary, criminal justice, different areas, your little comments you make make a difference in somebody's life forever. Some of the faculty here have made that impression on you. I hope that Great Bay did. As being the CEO of a hospital in this community, we are so fortunate to have this school here. I want you to have passion about what you do going forward, but always, always be true to yourself. If you're ever in work situations where it doesn't feel right, please listen to yourself. That's how you succeed. That's how Will succeeded. That's how I did. Because at the end of the day, this is your journey. And this is just the beginning. And I really think you should all be so proud of yourselves, of what you accomplished. And I think you, after you're partying tonight, and when you're like, you know, maybe in a few days, buy your parents, buy somebody, go get a card. If you can't tell them how much their influence is, because you didn't do this alone. Congratulations. I look forward to seeing you out in the workforce. Do us proud in New Hampshire. And take that passion with you forever. Thank you.
Thank you, Anne, for that lovely address. I will next introduce Mike Marr from the System of Community Colleges, who will award the Chancellor's Award for Teaching Excellence and the Chancellor's Award for Service Excellence. Mike?
Good morning. On behalf of Dr. Richard Gustafson, congratulations and best of luck in the future. I'm pleased to present the Chancellor's Award for Teaching Excellence to Dr. Leslie Barber. Dr. Barber is the chair of the Life Science and Biotechnology Department. Her colleagues report that it's hard not to be excited about science when you're around her. Leslie embodies the academic rigor in research and has worked with her knowledgeable department to build a strong and respected program. She knows that students can be overwhelmed by the subject area and works hard to make sure students are as successful as they can be. As department chair, she is a strong advocate for her programs and the instructors, and she works to build a community of instructors with her department, including full-time and adjunct faculty. Her recent accomplishments include developing the new natural resources courses offered in partnership with the UNH Cooperative Extension. Her work connected Great Bay and the New Hampshire Network of Biomedical Research Excellence, which resulted in the placement of two of our students in a summer research program at Dartmouth College this year. Her strong connections with UNH have strengthened collaboration and transfer opportunities in the sciences area. She manages 5 grants and is always looking for new ways to motivate her students. Leslie is an advocate for faculty rights and responsibilities. Her insights are respected and valued by her colleagues, and she is a strong contributor to shared governance and decision-making at the college. Please join me in honoring Dr. Leslie Barber with a Chancellor's Award for Teaching Excellence. Pleased to present the Chancellor's Award for Service Excellence to Jennifer Scotland, Program Assistant in the Business Training Center. Jennifer is something of an ambassador at Great Bay. She coordinates on-site training, including our training partnerships with the Portsmouth Naval Shipyard and a variety of other activities. She represents the college at regional Chamber of Commerce events and with the Pease Tenants Association. She has developed strong and productive networks with Tradeport businesses that have become a very positive asset for the college. Jennifer has worked Saturdays, Sundays, and at nights for many different college events. These events include or are related to the 45 police departments that depend on her for the police standards program, the APICS certification testing program, the National Electricians Update course, and the various job fairs, open houses, and recruitment activities. She also coordinates all the room reservations at the college. In the short time that Jen has been at Great Bay, she has exemplified commitments to the students and the college. She has taken on tasks well beyond the typical responsibilities in the Business and Training Center. Her rapport with the START program students is supportive and empowering. As advisor for Alternative Spring Break in Guatemala, she put in countless hours for club meetings, fundraising, and on the trip itself. Her fluency in Spanish was definitely an asset on the trip, especially when arguing to locate lost luggage. Please join me in honoring Jennifer Scotland with the Chancellor's Award for Service Excellence. Thank you, and congratulations again.
The Scholastic Awards are given to the students with the highest cumulative grade point average in each associate degree program. Yesterday, at the senior breakfast, these awards were given out. But today, we would like to honor these students' achievement by reading their names. I ask the student graduates awardees to please stand and be recognized as I call your names, and I ask that applause be held until all the names have been read. In accounting, Kristen Cora Forbes. In automotive, William G. Petropoulos. In biotechnology, Rebecca A. Corcoran. In computer technology, Lauren A. Andrews. In early childhood education, Tanya Marie Delisle. In hospitality management, Christopher Barry Kliska. In information system technology, Ryan R. Carino. In liberal arts, Charlene Eva Carides. Liberal arts American studies, Brian F. Dobson. Liberal arts business studies, Ryan R. Snyder. Liberal arts engineering science, Philip M. Barron II. Liberal arts teacher prep, Jessica L. Prosser. Management, Krista Cora Forbes. Massage therapy, Enid Torrey Patton. Nursing, Kelly A. Collier Driscoll. Surgical technology, Laura Parsons Dowling. Veterinary technology, Laura Christine Smith. We congratulate you on your achievement.
In nominating her as one of the 10 most influential people on the Seacoast, Jay Levy of Merrill Lynch called Renee Plummer the go-to matriarch of either initiating or assisting in coordinating the community, business, and political events that have left their trademark on the Portsmouth landscape for a number of years. Dan Hoefley, a lawyer and chairman of the Foundation of Seacoast Health, said the woman who is number 3 on the Seacoast 10 Most Influential People's list is a big talent, a bigger personality, and has the biggest heart on the Seacoast. And Mark Sullivan of Seacoast Management Asset Management, Leadership Seacoast, and a Seacoast local called her the person of whom the most is asked in our Seacoast community, whether it's the USS New Hampshire Commissioning, the Boston Portsmouth Air Show, the Scarecrows of Portsmouth, I don't know what that is, but the Exeter Hospital Snowball, her instrumental involvement in making peace, International Trade Port, what it is today, countless anonymous donations, or so many other issues and events that my memory cannot just recall all of them. You can say a lot about our honorary degree recipient, but one thing you can't say is that she's a wilting flower. She is always effervescently in bloom. I first met Renee Plummer shortly after I arrived here as president in 2007. In these 4 years, I have come to be an admirer of her many wondrous gifts and talents. She, along with her husband Dan, is an accomplished commercial real estate developer. Together, they have played a significant role in the development of Peace International Trade Port, one of the most successful transformations of a military installation to commercial use ever. Because of their tireless efforts, today Peace Trade Port houses over 200 companies and over 7,000 employees. Suffice it to say that they are wonderfully successful in business, that they work very hard, that they expect a lot from those who work with them. Having financial success is the goal for many people, but that does not begin to sum up who Renee is as a human being. The most intriguing thing about Renee is her heart. A more caring, giving person I have yet to meet. She gives money to many organizations throughout the Seacoast. Again, this is something that many giving and caring people do. Most importantly, though, Renee gives herself, her mind, her skills, and her love for everything that she touches. She brokers, she facilitates, and then she watches to make sure that whatever collaboration she creates works well. Because of her efforts, countless Seacoast organizations and people have benefited. She is especially a strong advocate for young people and spends time mentoring and changing their lives. Most recently, she spent time with 10 of our most promising business students, mentoring and providing advice on what it takes to be successful in business. Renee did not have the opportunity to go to college. Instead, she graduated from the School of Hard Knocks. But in the process, she has earned a PhD in being human and living life the right way. And she will be the first to say that there is nothing that you can't do if you believe it and you work hard to gain it. It is my honor and pleasure to bestow upon Renee Plummer an Associate in Arts degree for all that she has accomplished personally and for her community and for the many things that are yet still to come. Renee, you need to come up here. There you are.
Finally.
Thank you.
If you ever get a chance to meet this woman, Dusa, it's one. She's a wonderful, wonderful person.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, next. The President's Award is given to an adjunct faculty and a student that has excelled or done something special to advance the college over the past year. This year, the President's Adjunct Award goes to Christine Whitney. In the absence of a program director for surgical technology, the entire adjunct faculty went above and beyond to help make the program run this past year. Kristen, however, stepped into a leadership role. Kristen has been a clinical coordinator for 3 years, but this year, in addition, she taught 3 classes for surgical technology, as well as informally assuming a major advising role. She provided logistical support for the program for everything from ordering supplies and making sure that the new equipment was installed and integrated according to program needs. She did clinical tracking and instituted electronic case logging. She has taken on the role as program coordinator so that students and other adjuncts will have a more readily available contact with field expertise and for support and questions. She coordinated the preceptor reception and the pinning ceremony and helped with scheduling textbook ordering, and catalog revision. She has been consistent in supporting academic affairs with the necessary information for the accreditation reports, having taken on the reports herself by the end of the academic year. She also provided valuable insight on the complexities of the program curriculum and clinical tracking and procedures for some of the typical academic affairs issues that occurred throughout the year. She is a graduate of the program and has taken on all these extra responsibilities because of her sincere desire to support the program and the college in the absence of a permanent director. Kristen? The President's Award for Student Leadership goes to Brian Dobson. Woo-hoo! Brian has served honorably in his role as the President of the Student Government Association. Under his direction, Student Government Association has achieved the following: dedicated a granite bench to honor all past, current, and future GBCC community members that serve in the military. Collected and donated over 20 Thanksgiving baskets to families in the greater Seacoast community. Extended library hours during finals for students. The SGA did this by volunteering to work in the library. Created a monthly lunch series to bring all club and organization presidents together to discuss issues. Outside of his Student Government Association role, Brian has been a wonderful friend to the college by participating in the college's annual legislative breakfast and other important meetings. He serves the wider community as a member of the National Guard and as trustee on the New Hampshire Post-Secondary Education Commission. Brian will be going on to UNH this fall and will also remain in our community as a part-time employee. Brian? Who's next? Next, it is my distinct honor to present the student speaker, Kristen Silva.
Good morning. I'd like to give another extended welcome to family, friends, faculty, and of course, my fellow graduates. This is it. We're moments away from receiving our diplomas, and our time here at Great Bay Community College will be completed. Some of us will be moving on to continue our education, and others, like myself, will be starting our lives as professionals from this day forward. I don't know about you, but I'm excited to start this new chapter in my life. And while I am nervous, I'm ready. I'm ready to embrace my future, in large part, to this college providing me with the necessities of not only my profession, but with my life and how I choose to carry it. For those of you who don't know, I graduated from the University of New Hampshire in 2008 with a bachelor's degree in English. I know, I did things a little backwards. I often tell people that I prepared for my associates in science by getting a bachelor's in English first. Because obviously they're related. While I joke from time to time about progressing through school in a somewhat unconventional manner, the truth is that my 4 years at UNH were spent being unsure about where I saw myself in the professional world. As a result, I waited for time to pass and eventually graduate rather than take advantage of what the college had to offer. My experience at Great Bay has been vastly different in the best ways possible. Perhaps it's because I'm older, or perhaps it's because my classes were more profession-oriented. But mostly, the gift I received from this school is because I had a direction that led me towards becoming a veterinary technician. The gift I received is quite simple: a desire to learn and an eagerness to be involved. Prior to my enrollment at Great Bay, I was by no means a good student. Aside from struggling to stay above a C average, my attitude was extremely poor. If I didn't find a class to be of any importance to my future, then I wouldn't care to put forth any effort. I'd rarely study, and by rarely I mean never. And if I didn't understand something, I'd give up and accept that I don't know it. As I mentioned earlier, my education at Great Bay was significantly different. I studied, for one thing. I studied a lot. And while I won't miss those numerous hours, the reward for all of my effort was exciting. Settling for mediocre wasn't good enough for me anymore. I began thriving on the challenge of success rather than the ease of skating by. Naturally, confidence followed shortly after I tasted this educational success. I've experienced so many years of doing rather poorly in school that I began to believe that perhaps I'm not the scholarly type. However, I learned that I can survive school. Moreover, I can exceed my own expectations. While I was constantly frustrated with struggling through school in the past, I feel extremely fortunate now, because without that struggle, I couldn't truly appreciate the value of all the hard work that I put into my years here. Unfortunately, I used to consider college solely for the purpose of getting a degree. I figured I'd learn the essential skills of my career when I get there. A major lesson I learned is that college may not be a career, but you should treat it like one. Because how you are as a student reflects how you are as a working individual. I can honestly say from experience that the effort put into my studies is exponentially more valuable than the grades I receive for it. Grades are a complement and secondary to the hard work behind them. For those of you continuing your education, I strongly recommend looking at school this way, if you don't already, because it's easier to give in or get caught up with a grade point average than it is to acknowledge the reward for devoting numerous hours to even one class. We don't get grades in the real world. We'll be evaluated on our work ethic, and our success will be measured by how hard we work in addition to our competency. Challenge yourself to work through a math problem you don't understand instead of passing it by. Go through those flashcards one more time. Reread a confusing sentence to make sense of it. And don't pass in anything you're not proud of. Sometimes you really don't want to, but if you can develop that kind of attitude in school, I promise it will carry over into the professional world. When I graduated the University of New Hampshire, one of the first things I said was, I'm never going to school again. Well, clearly, I was wrong. The truth is, going back to school is one of the greatest decisions I've ever made. For those of you who are ending your college career today, take full advantage of the working world, but don't eliminate the possibility of going back to school if you want to advance or even want to go in a completely different direction. If I didn't decide to travel a path opposite of my English degree, I wouldn't be as happy as I am today. My unexpected extra 2 years of school is undoubtedly worth what I hope will be a lifetime in a career I love. Graduating is especially important to me this time around because I feel that I have grown in a measurable amount. It's not time to graduate, it's deserved. And I'm ready to carry over what I learned here to the world out there. Ultimately, that's what graduation is. Time to apply what we learned in classes to wherever our next steps take us. So, when you walk this platform, walk it proudly, because it's your turn to prove how competent and successful you will be as a working professional. More importantly, it's time to prove to yourself that you can be greater than you imagined. Congratulations, class of 2011. It's more than deserved.
Will today's graduates please rise? President Arvelo, I present to you the students of the class of 2011 who have fulfilled the requirements for a degree or certificate. President Arvelo.
By virtue of the authority vested in me by the state, by the Constitution of the State of New Hampshire and the laws of the State of New Hampshire, I have the honor to present the appropriate degree to those candidates who have met the requirements of their respective curriculum with all the rights, honors, and privileges pertaining thereto. You may be seated.
Following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Accounting, Sarah A. Bollier. Sherry Lynn Beausoleil, also receiving the degree of Associate in Science in Management. Jared Charles Brown. Kristen Cora Forbes, also receiving the Associate of Science in Management. Crystal T. Jellin. Tatiana V. Yaroshevich. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Biotechnology. Michelle Lynn Collette. Katie M. Dudley. Ronald and Andrew Faylong. Tiffany A. Gill. Alan Hasanich. Elizabeth Marie Hogan. Erin Teresa Faden. The following is a candidate for the professional certificate in biotechnology. Kimberly May Singulis. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Computer Technology. John Robert Joseph Caswell, also receiving the Certificate in Digital Design and Animation. Andrew Homer Esley. Julia Foster. John P. Harrell. Daniel W. Russell, also receiving the Certificate in Digital Design and Animation. Jordan William South. Tyler James Watts, also receiving the Certificate in Programming. The following are candidates for the Certificate in Digital Design and Animation. Jonathan David LaPlante. Sally Diane Quirrell. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Criminal Justice. Lauren A. Andrews, also receiving the Certificate in Homeland Security. James C. DeRosius. Tyler J. Kerr. Stanley W. Parsons. Andrew C.J. Raffinello. Kristen Rose Vassell, also receiving the Certificate in Homeland Security. Sean T. Wilton. The following are candidates for the Certificate in Homeland Security. Pamela Lee Cotter. Danielle Kristen Ganley Dutton, also receiving the degree of Associate in Arts and Liberal Arts. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Early Childhood Education. Lauren Nicole Bourgeois, also receiving the certificate in ECE Special Education. Tanya Marie Delisle. Courtney Elizabeth Kazera. Jamie Millison Moore. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Hospitality Management. Christopher Barry Kliska. Anna Lissa Schaefer. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Information Systems Technology. Matthew C. White. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Arts in Liberal Arts. Sarah Jean Beckford, also receiving the certificate in Medical Coding. Elizabeth Carol Brown. Evelyn Laney Brown. Nicole Elizabeth Childers. Ashley Estelle Clark. Adrielle Marie DeScheitner. Megan Anna DeVoe. Paula Mella Talabong Isarina. Kathleen Ann Kelly. David G. Kernan. Robert C. Reynolds. Katie Lee Smart. Michael S. Tuttle. Izio H. Yuki. Following is a candidate for the degree of Associate in Arts in Liberal Arts American Studies, Brian F. Dobson. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Arts in Liberal Arts Teacher Preparation, Kerry Way Gilman, Jessica L. Prosser, also receiving the Certificate in Special Education, Amanda Lauren Swift. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Management, Cody J. DeLong, Christopher Mark McGrail. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Massage Therapy, Candace Cantalupo, Shauna L. McLellan, Enid Torrey Patton. The following are candidates for the Certificate in Medical Coding, Kara Arzigian, Susan Marie Grillo, Roxanne M. Perry. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Nursing, Emily J. Allen, Cheryl Ann Ariel, Jennifer Ann Audia, Megan Bartley, Nicole D. Cardinal, Holly Marie Denard, Tiffany Lynn DiVincenzo, Sarah A. Earle, Christiane Franzen, Rachel Marie Frost, Jade Marie Green, Jaylene A. Harrington, Karen S. Hyder, Paris M. Herc, Christine Marie Kennedy, Nicole M. LaChapelle, Barbara Ann Laganier, Jennifer M. Littlefield, Lydia Marcucci, Tina M. Michaud Gray, Joan M. Page, Ashley Rose Finney, Robert James Scammon II, Michael T. Warwick Soule. The following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Surgical Technology, Courtney Christine Bedard, Lori Lynn Carey, Jessica Ann Carnavelli, Donna J. Cody, Tia Marie Crouch, Laura Parsons Dowling, Ferry Effendi, Suzanne A. Landroche, Johan M. McEachran, Danielle Marie Martineau, Jennifer Jones Smith, Sandra C. Tara Vaccarella, the following are candidates for the degree of Associate in Science in Veterinary Technology. Jessica Marie Appiani. Kelly Erin Bauman. Jamie Lee Beers. Sarah Marjorie DeFusco. Laura Noelle Dutton. Chelsea Genevieve Duval. Susan Victoria Gale. Carolyn M. Gould. Brian Stewart Harris Jones. Dina Jositis. Rebecca Ann Willett. Christina Marie Patrickman. Chantel Marie Pelletier. Mary Catherine Pichet. Brian J. Robertson. Suzette Nicole St. Pierre. Andrea M. Saunders. Anne Catherine Schaefer. Sarah Colby Shorns. Christy Lynn Silva. Ashley Larmy Simpson. Nina Marie Soares. Holly Ann Westover.
Will our graduates please rise? Please move your tassel from the right to the left. Honored guests, family, and friends, I present to you the class of 2011. You may be seated. I would like to remind everyone that following this ceremony, there will be a reception In the cafeteria and in the grand entranceway for those who care to join us for some celebration. And I also would like to remind you that today's ceremony has been broadcast live via streaming video. And those of you who would like to say a personal message to anybody, any one of your loved ones who may be viewing, may do so with Mike McNeil at the end of the ceremony. And with that, I'd like to reintroduce Sister Helen, who will give the benediction. Thank you very much.
The class of 2011, rejoice. You are no longer candidates, but recipients of the degrees and certificates that yesterday remained but dreams, awaiting this formal confirmation. Those official documents connote the approval, or blessing, if you will, of Great Bay Community College, its trustees, administrators, faculty, and staff. Authorized endorsement of the significant things you have accomplished here. However, before departing, we must not let you leave without sharing our hopes and dreams, the blessings or gifts that we trust have become part of you, not for today only, but forever. May you always maintain an inquiring mind and strive to be lifelong learners. Seek truth, be joyful in prosperity, and able to retain your personal peace in adversity. Carry with you an irrevocable consciousness of the individual and professional accountability that you have freely assumed in the acceptance of your awards today. On this campus, you started something great, and you have finished something great. You leave with the potential to kindle a spark of greatness and the many lives you will touch along the way. Let your light shine. Thank you.
Thank you.